Sup, giggler?
Gary, fix the Wi-Fi.
Manifest that shit.
We can't be managed. I mean, the day just got away from me.
What is up, my greatest of all time gigglers, aka the goats?
Wow. That was a really good, yeah, that was good.
It's a big difference when I put in 10 seconds of preparation right before the pod.
Yeah, my mom says that all the time. It's crazy what you could do if you just use your brain for a little.
You just try a little.
Yeah, I'm like, why would I do that?
Welcome to another episode. You know that we never introduce ourselves? I just thought about it. Like, some people probably don't even know our names. People are like, hi, I'm Hannah Berner, and I'm with
Paige. So I forgot my name for a second.
And that's why we don't introduce ourselves, because honestly, it's like, too much to remember.
What's my name? I just signed a contract the other day, and my assistant emailed me back, and she said, sorry, small problem. You spelled your name wrong. I was like, sick.
You know that the SATs, you like get points for your name?
Yeah.
So you lost points there?
Probably.
Also, humble brag that you have an assistant.
Sorry, it was actually my agent's assistant, but I didn't want to go into so much detail, but I do have an assistant, but yeah, she doesn't know anything about contracts.
But that you're like, but she doesn't know it. I just make her do stuff. She doesn't know she works for me. Okay, I just have to get to it. I wrote artichokes down.
Yeah.
People don't talk about artichokes enough.
Okay.
It is the most underrated thing to get in an Italian restaurant.
How are you getting them prepared?
Thank you for asking. Breaded with olive oil.
Okay, so you're the kind that you like put on your mouth and you...
Basically, you use the artichoke as a vehicle.
Yeah, for the breaded.
For the bread, yeah, and the olive oil. And it's magnificent and no one talks about it.
Okay, I will only get it prepared that way. I don't like when they like fry it and it's like shriveled up and it's almost like a chip.
No, absolutely not. Then it turns into like you might as well eat kale.
Does that have anything to do with the other thing you wrote down on the list about shitting yourself? Or is that a completely different story?
Okay, let's get into it. It doesn't have to do with it, but an artichoke could make me shit myself.
Anything really could make you shit
yourself. Honestly, a strong breeze could make me shit myself.
Yeah, I was just going to say, gust of wind right to the stomach, you're shitting on the street.
The worst part about getting married was for like 4 days, I was like, what is going to cause me to like bloat and... be horrible and shitting myself, because you can't be like shitting and peeing the whole time with these wedding dresses.
Did you have a nervous pee? Some people, like before they walk down the aisle, they get like a nervous pee, and you before shows you have to take a nervous poop. Did you have one before the wedding?
Absolutely. It's like they get your dress all perfect, so I'm like, wait, can I take this off real quick and throw it on the floor? I did my nervous pee. Also, right beforehand, I got like kind of lightheaded because I realized I hadn't eaten.
Yeah, you did.
And they had these like turkey rolls, and I was just shoving my face with turkey rolls before I went down the aisle. So like all day I was preparing to like not look bloated, and then I was like, "You, you're mine, buddy."
With sodium.
Yeah. But I was like, it's turkey, it's healthy. And my mom was just rolling her eyes.
It's also like you're there, you're walking down the aisle. What it's gonna like.
What's how fast can it go through me? Pretty fast. Right. Pretty fast, let's be honest. But one thing that models do besides put one foot in front of the other, which is impressive.
Yeah.
Is like they constantly have to make sure they're not bloating.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm like an abnormal bloater. Like I'll bloat and people will ask me when I'm due.
Okay. Do you know that that's not normal? Like, okay, it's normal if you have a lactose problem, but mm-hmm. you might have like an actual
I think I have IBS. I thought it was just trolls on Instagram calling me a name, but now I realize I think they were diagnosing me with a certain...
Anna, you could also have something more serious than IBS.
What?
Yeah, like, I don't want to... I don't want to freak you out, but like you could, I am a doctor.
Okay, WebMD. Like you're like you have cancer.
You could have like endometriosis. One of like the major signs is that you bloat after everything you eat.
This is the thing. I'm tired all the time. I'm bloated all the time. Is that just me, or do I have endometriosis? Because I've stabilized.
Are you just a sleepy, body positive girl? Like, I don't know. Or do you have a problem?
Oh, my God.
Does your bloat hurt?
Sometimes.
Okay, I don't know the answer to sometimes. I didn't actually go to medical school.
I feel like I'm 30 and by this age I should know like what triggers me bloating, but honestly, it could be anything. I think it's anxiety, and that's why.
Interesting.
Because IBS could be triggered by anxiety. But then I have friends who have IBS, and they're on these strict diets. They're like, yeah, I don't eat cheese. I don't eat that. And I'm like.
Yeah, that's, I mean, if you had IBS, if you went to a doctor and they said, Hannah, we're sorry to inform you, you have IBS, you'd be like, cool, I'm going to just live the same way. But if they said you had something different, I feel like then you would make maybe some changes.
Yeah, yeah. So you don't have like crazy bloats? You don't like balloon?
So speaking of artichokes. No, I mean, I feel like I bloat when I eat a lot of dairy, but like it's when I eat like mac and cheese, then pizza, then like more pasta. And I only really bloat when I have my period.
You're like, if I didn't bloat, I'd be worried. I've wanted to know, because I feel like everyone has that story of if they've shat themselves before. Have you ever shat yourself in public?
I don't know if everyone has a story about shitting themselves. Have I ever shit myself?
The fact that
in
you're taking
public?
So long to answer means you have.
No, I no. I would say
you've never sharted. It's a shit fart. You think you're gonna fart and shit comes out?
No.
And any gigglers that just got grossed out?
I have
out?
Peed the bed before, like not drunk, like just legit peed the bed.
How old?
I was in college. But I wasn't, like, hungover. I didn't, like, drink. It was, like,
a dream
Tuesday morning. I have no idea. And I woke up and I just had, like, peed the bed. So does that count?
No.
Have you shit, like, on the street?
In a bodega.
Like, in the bathroom?
No.
Like, in the frozen food
aisle?
It was,
like, recent. It was, like, recent. I was sitting eating, like, a bacon, egg, and cheese, as one does. And I went to, like, fart, and it came out wet, and I was wearing yoga pants, and it, like...
Stuck right to it.
I felt it, like...
And you weren't wearing underwear.
I was.
Okay.
So I went in the bathroom.
Is this why you wear granny panties?
Yes. A granny panty, people don't talk about it. It will trap it. It trapped it.
Who were you with?
Alone. So I went to the bathroom, and of course, the second you go into the bathroom to do something important.
Wait, are you one of those people that can go and sit somewhere and eat by yourself and not feel weird?
Love eating by myself.
Wow.
Love it.
Good for you.
I love to like fully enjoy the food and not feel judged while I'm eating.
I don't think I've ever sat anywhere alone and ate something.
It's like my favorite thing to do.
Have you ever gone to the movies by yourself?
No. I'm not a loser.
Right. Okay, so back to you shitting in a bodega.
Oh yeah, back to me. You know, whenever you go to the bathroom, when you like need like a couple moments in the bathroom,
yeah.
Immediately people start knocking. Yeah. You're like, oh. So people are knocking. I take my I take my yoga pants off. I take my granny panties off.
I throw them away. Yeah.
I put water on like any soiled parts of the yoga pants. I put it back on.
Oh my
and
God.
I've never felt more disgusting in my life. And then I told myself it happens to everyone. That's why I asked it to you today to make me feel better. But you told me that I'm a bloated, shitting little fuck. And I now feel worse than ever. She's like,
once I like kind of peed my bed a tiny bit. I just don't think people are running around shitting. What do you think it
Pat,
was?
Pat, have you ever shot yourself?
No.
Okay, objection.
I don't think he's
objection.
Lying.
Objection. I have. Thank you.
Where? Sorry. Okay, that anything under 10, not liable for.
But it traumatized you?
No, because he was a child.
Well, you don't know how it traumatized you, but it did.
Out of diapers.
You haven't processed it. You haven't healed yet.
Oh, my God. Who'd you tell besides everyone just now?
I don't think I told Dez.
I mean, because it was pre-wedding.
Yeah, this is what happens. After the wedding, he's going to start figuring out some shit.
Literally. What do you think it was?
I was trying to be a hero, and I thought that I could fart when I couldn't.
I do have a story.
What did you do?
The first time I ever smoked a cigarette, like ever in my life, I think I was like in college and everyone was like doing it. And I took one puff, immediately had to run to the bathroom to shit myself.
Wait, does it cause you to poop?
Yeah, I think so. Because I'd like never.
The adrenaline.
I don't know if it's the adrenaline or just like pure tar heroin that they like fucking put in cigarettes that I just was like, I have to shit immediately. Wow. I mean, I kept it inside my body until, but it was like a near death experience.
That's like the one time I did cocaine and I immediately got a nosebleed.
We just can't do substances. I think that's how people
someone
who smoke
forced me, I won't say who, somebody forced me to try cocaine for the first time
and you just
I got a nosebleed immediately. Like I was like hanging and then
I feel like our moms would be really proud. They're like, yeah. Or they'll be like losers, they can't even do coke and smoke cigs. But that must be why how people who smoke cigarettes in like France stay so skinny. They're just shitting all the time.
Yeah, but people don't talk about this is what the pot is called. People don't talk about when I heard like Johnny Depp smokes all the time, I was like, like show me the hottest dude.
Wait, they said that on like the trial?
He's constantly
smoking cigs.
To his own like hand rolled tobacco, like he's always smoking cigs.
You would think that Johnny Depp is from like the countryside of France.
Yeah.
This man's from,
where's he from?
I think like the Midwest.
Oh my, where?
Kentucky? No,
he
no
says
way.
Kentucky and then goes, I don't know.
Wait, can you Google that, Pat? Because if this man actually has a southern accent, I'll lose my mind.
Like he had one and then now he's like the Madonna of male actors where you don't know. And he's not human. You don't know where he's from. He just came out that way. Kentucky.
That is insane.
You get a raise.
That's insane.
I want to get early on dope documentaries / some pop culture because we have to get in the Johnny Depp Amber Heard trial.
Okay, but I also have much to say about
the wedding.
The Kravis wedding.
Oh, my God. Okay, we have so much to cover. Sorry for that quick
poop story. Every pod needs one.
Just warming you guys
up.
Don't
feel bad about shitting on the street today.
Yeah, it happens to me. So I watch a documentary by the New York Times about juuling.
Okay.
It's the same. It's called the ones that did Framing Britney Spears. It's like in that same series. And it's about how Juul was founded. Do you know anything about the history of it?
No.
These two really smart dudes in college were supposed to invent something that makes something that's already out there better.
Okay.
And the guy, like he had family that passed.
He was like things that kill people.
Yeah.
Let's do
so
that.
So like
one.
Lung cancer. Great. Was in his family and he really was passionate about making smoking better for you. Like making it less bad.
Didn't they make it infinitely worse?
So that was not the OG plan.
Okay.
They were actually like Mother Teresa. We're going to help people stop smoking these cigarettes and smoke a better option.
Okay.
But when people were hitting it, there wasn't enough nicotine in it.
Okay.
So they started adding some more nicotine and they added the flavors. And next thing you know, the experience got so fucking good. And then they started getting people wanting to invest in it. And then next thing you know, big tobacco invests in them, gives them billions of dollars. So like they started off like wanting to do well and then turned into.
Do they still own it?
One of the guys left and the other guy's like on the board, but basically Big Tobacco's running it now. And they also are getting under a lot of heat because they didn't market to kids, but they didn't not market to kids.
Right.
And they were like, did not expect that kids were going to love it so much. And like millions of kids are smoking Juuls.
So
like middle school kids are smoking Juuls now.
That's crazy.
When like a couple years ago, they had gotten smoking in middle school to like nothing. And now it's just spiked.
My experience with that, like I was 25 when Juuls came out. Mm. And my experience was if there were clubs that you could smoke cigarettes in, were people doing it? Yes. Mm. But cigarette smoke always used to make me so nauseous and also make me shit myself. So I was just like not a big like cigarette girl.
Yeah.
And then when people would be out and you'd be at a bar, you'd just be like, oh, hit this. Like, it's just nicotine. It's like nothing else. And then you get addicted. And I smoked. I mean, it's probably the number one thing my mother hates about me the most, that I smoked for years. And as of last week, I started the nicotine patches.
So that's actually what they recommended for people to get off Juuling, because people in the company just were like, we quit the company because we don't like, we realize we're working for Big Tobacco now, and that wasn't the initial cause. So they're doing nicotine gum and patches to get off.
Because it is disgusting, and I quit not only because is it just like so gross, but it's totally aging me. So I was like, wow, I had to get to like a vein point.
Well, I think
to quit
for this, I know for your skin and stuff, it can't be good to have like.
But if
smoke.
You have anxiety, like, because I am again a web MD doctor,
yeah,
like. If you have really bad anxiety, you're more prone to becoming addicted to things because it's like a crutch or you like lean on it.
It's a soothing. It's self-soothing.
And I was never like a big drinker where it was like if I drank one day, like hell no, am I drinking the next day? But people would become like alcoholics if you have bad anxiety because you like crutch on it. Mm-hmm. And mine became that.
Can we do this together? Because I feel like there are definitely gigglers out there and we love you. Who were like you, who weren't smokers, and yeah. somehow started Juuling, and it was cool.
And then you're full on addicted.
If you've been waiting for a sign to quit, Paige just quit.
I ordered it on like Amazon.
Get some nicotine patches, nicotine gum.
My mom
would
put
off.
Nicotine gum in every Christmas in my stocking since I was 25.
Did she really?
Yeah. She was like, please stop. You're killing me.
What does it feel like to be addicted to something?
It's different because, like, it's not... Okay, so it's not like you're addicted to, like, heroin where you're, like, yeah. one bad thing and, like, it's done.
It wasn't ruining your life.
It wasn't ruining my life, but it's, like, it's hard as a younger... Like, someone in their early 20s to think, like, wow, in 20 years, like, my lung's probably just going to explode. Like, you can't think in that mindset. Yeah. And then now that I'm about to be 30 and I'm like, should I get Botox? And then it's like, well, no, I'm probably going to need it earlier because of this fucking thing. Mm-hmm. And it's just like gross.
Yeah.
Like it's a turnoff.
Yeah.
It started to become a real turnoff to me.
So when other people did it.
No, just like watching myself, like knowing it was always in my pocket yeah. or like knowing like, fuck, I'm going to go to the bathroom and like hit this because I can't like hit it in front of whoever I'm with.
Yeah. You know, when you're hiding something that like yourself, you're deep down, you know, it's wrong.
Yes.
Once even like, yeah, your subconscious.
If
is
you
telling
can't do
you,
it in front of your grandma and you feel bad about it, you whatever it is.
Depends
you
on your grandma. My grandma's pretty. Hip.
Yeah,
she'd
but I'm
like, what's that?
I don't think your grandma would like knowing I smoked a Juul.
She would not because she cares not. About skin more than anything. Right. But they showed this like 14-year-old girl who like their bodies I don't think can handle the amount of smoke. And like she basically said like she was having trouble breathing, their lungs are fucking caving in.
Well,
like
because
it's bad.
You're not even like fully developed.
No. So I
this is a great if you're looking for a sign to quit. Get
Let's
the
do it together.
Yeah, get
Giggler's
the
getting
patch.
Off Juul.
Giggler's getting off drugs.
Say no to drugs. Say no to Juuls. Don't do drugs by rugs. That's your new Amazon show. That's your new home decor Amazon show. Yeah, I just came up with that. Can we talk about the Johnny Depp Amber Heard trial?
Yeah.
I was very, very into it the first like week or two, whatever. They took a week off and now I'm like getting back on. Do you have any thoughts?
I feel like it's turned into like a star-studded event. Like Kate Moss is about to appear. Mm-hmm. Like this documentary
is going to be
epic. The number one thing I'm taking away from it is Johnny Depp is like such an interesting person because they had a recording of him saying to her like, you will never be able to look me in the eyes ever again, and it was like the last time they ever spoke. Mm-hmm. And he has not once looked at her during the trial. The like composure and self, what is the word,
control,
yes, mm-hmm. that he has is insane.
Well, some people are saying he's the victim because he can't look at his abuser, and then some people are saying that he's super
feels
controlling
bad. Yeah.
That he's still controlling how everything's going along. So there's that like the
or
world
he's just
is divided.
A great actor and he's now in this role of like They're both
actors. But everyone can agree that these motherfuckers were in a toxic situation.
I think they're both nuts. Like, there's no way dating Johnny Depp wasn't nuts.
For sure.
I mean,
oh my God.
How insane.
Oh my God.
This before all of the Amber Heard stuff happened, and now I do feel a little awkward having it.
What do you like about it?
I love Kate Moss.
You just thought
it was hot? I'm a huge Kate Moss fan. I just thought it was cool.
Why do you like Kate Moss? I like don't know anything about her.
Me neither.
You're like, she's British.
And she's chic. And I don't know. Chic. And she smokes cigarettes and doesn't shit herself.
Or she does.
And that's why she stays so skinny.
Yeah.
No, she was just like, she was like a top model in the 90s and she like defied it because she was only 5'6".
Yeah.
Yeah. And she's like the courage.
Are you 5'5"?
5'4". But no, I just always thought she was like a cool fashion icon.
Yeah.
And so I didn't know what to put here. And then one of my girlfriends was like, why don't we blow this picture up? It's kind of cool. And now I feel awkward. I mean, every time my dad comes in here, I definitely feel awkward.
Because Kate Moss's nipples out?
Slightly.
Honestly, normalize the nip.
Slightly.
Slightly. It's love, but I'm interested to hear what she says about it. But the point is this is turning into reality TV where, like, if you go deep into anyone's past relationships, like, that ended badly, you're going to hear some weird shit.
Some fucked up shit.
You're going to hear the, like, imagine if people recorded phone calls of fights you've had.
Oh, God.
I mean, that's what we did on TV, but it's like, yeah, it doesn't make sense.
Here's the other thing I will say. As you get older, do you ever look back into relationships and you're just like, yes, that was crazy, but you kind of give yourself like, okay, but I was 22. Like, I would never do that now.
Oh, for sure. Because you are learning what relationships are and you're learning your boundaries and you're learning what you can and cannot handle from people and what kind of disrespect you tolerate.
So, like, I know that I definitely, if someone recorded, like, my phone calls with the guy I dated from at, like, 23, I would look like an absolute psychopath.
That's why when they play the recordings, I'm like, oh, this is fucked up.
Yeah.
But they're trying to get a sense of, like, right and wrong when it's honestly the trial. It's tough. It's going down to the wire of what's going to happen. But I do think.
Well, also, Johnny Depp's lawyers are just like so much better than Amber Heard's.
Johnny Depp's lawyers. People are trying to say that Camille and Johnny Depp are fucking, which we hate. Just because a girl's hot and powerful does not mean she's fucking her client.
She's definitely not.
No.
But also, how great would that be for the documentary?
That'd be amazing for the documentary. Subscribe. I'd watch that. Mental health moment. I saw something on TikTok that you reminded me of.
Okay.
Women are taught to give respect before they get it.
Mm-hmm.
And men are taught to wait till they get respect before they give it.
Spot on. Write it on my tombstone.
Isn't that fucking crazy?
Yeah.
Because it's so true.
It's so true. And I feel like you don't realize it until you're like a working woman, like out of college.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh, for sure. Because you're not around people who are your friends, who understand you, who respect you. You're just with people and you see how you need to earn respect in every room you go into.
Right.
And if you don't immediately respect someone.
Yeah.
Because you have a bad vibe from like a dude or something. That doesn't go well for you.
That is like my number one like talking point for all girls high school. Like every time I say I went to an all girls high school, they're like, oh my God, were you so crazy? Were you such a slut? Blah, blah, blah. That's beside the point.
Not the point.
Not the point. Okay. Not the point. The number one thing.
I didn't think you were going to go that way.
Can we give blowjobs? Heck yeah, we can. But.
What do you think our seminars are about? What do you think our homework is?
Think in-class suspension was just fucking around all day? No, we were learning things. No, but I think like the number one thing from an all-girls high school that you learn that you don't realize you're learning while you're in high school is that there's no men around. So, like, you don't even think about it. So, like, leadership roles in high school, you're not competing against guys. Mm-hmm. If you're raising your hand, you get it wrong. You're not, like, embarrassed because Jenny next to you, who's like stuffing her face with like chips, gives a fuck that you got it wrong. So right when you get to college and you're with guys, like you don't think that you're less than them for like a specific role in school, or like if you get the answer wrong, like you're not thinking about Jeremy, who like
but when,
can't read.
When men are in the positions of power and they get to choose which who they respect, then you start seeing like, oh shit, I need to like either suck up to these dudes.
Yeah, like, oh, you're not just not picking me because I'm a girl. Like, fuck you.
Oh my God.
When I give a great blowjob.
When I was in Wisconsin Athletics, I got this job to do sports broadcasting for a little bit. You can literally Google Hannah Burner Badgers. It's going to ruin your day.
Wait, someone came up to me the other day and was like, I'm from Wisconsin. And at the same time, we just said, go Badgers.
Go Badgers.
And Craig was like, wait, what? And I was like, you don't need
anywhere in the country, if someone's wearing like a Badger thing, you're like, go Badgers.
Yep.
So I was working the basketball thing. I'm like, I come from a family of basketball. Like my grandpa was a basketball coach.
I didn't know you came from a basketball family.
I'm from Brooklyn. That's like where basketball originated. But like my grandpa used to coach basketball in schools in Brooklyn. So anyway, I was born around it. And I sit down and the game's going. I clearly qualified in some way to get the job.
Okay.
And these men are baby talking me like, so when he scores this and he scores that, that means it's a double. Double. And I'm like, yeah, I got it. And this goes on the whole game.
Are you a freshman?
No, I'm a senior.
Yeah, okay.
I was a senior. But I was like interning at like where people actually work. But oh my God. And then when I went into like marketing, the meetings, I would say something and a guy would literally just repeat it to the boss, who was a guy. It would happen all the time. But then I went to sales, and in sales I just did my own thing, and it was just whoever like made most money.
Yeah.
And then when I was doing well, people were like, oh, Hannah does well because she like she's a girl and she like giggles on the phone a lot, which full circle,
made a whole career of it.
But then it's like they use it against you, like, oh, because that's why, because she's a girl. But anyway, long story short, if you're at your job and you're quit dueling and quit giving respect to men.
That's why I think people look down on OnlyFans, because it's a woman-dominated business.
Paige, why do you think people look down on influencers? That influencers, why did I have trouble saying that? Influencers have like a lack of respect that it's not a real job because it's female-dominated.
I know for a fact, anyone I've dated previously, except maybe one, I make more money than, for sure.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there's just no, I don't even need to run the numbers.
Mm-hmm.
I've run them in my head.
She goes, I don't have numbers, just, it's a lot, okay? I'm better than you. Do you want to be with a guy who makes more than you, though?
As I get older, I don't care as much.
I think it becomes
what a question.
I think it becomes less of the actual money and more of like where he is in his field and how passionate he is and what he does.
Right. Like, it's not that I want everything to fall on me financially.
No.
But if he does make less than me, like, but I need it to just be like equal.
Yeah. Well, you want to feel like you both are bringing something to the table.
Yeah, that we're both trying to make our lives easier.
Exactly. And you don't want to feel indebted to them, or they feel indebted to you. But you also don't want to feel like, or you want to be with a guy who's, I'd rather be with a guy who's so fucking proud of you and making less money than a guy who's like almost making as much money, but like is weirdly emasculated by it.
Correct.
I feel like we're getting to the advice segment. I feel like we're naturally there. I haven't seen you since the wedding, so this is a fun little catch-up.
Okay, let's do advice, and then I'm literally busting at the seams for Kravis.
I know. I'm making people wait. Okay. This girl says, this is so shallow, but I absolutely hate the photo my boyfriend uses for every single social.
Tell him. Just tell him.
I've done to Dez. I've literally taken
his phone. Because you want to know what? He's not going to be offended by it because he doesn't know.
He has no idea.
He has no idea. He just liked that shirt he was wearing that day. He threw that picture out. He doesn't know.
Yeah, Dez has like all these gorgeous professional photos of himself, and then he picked like a self, like in the moment he did the selfie, like at the beach, and I was like,
no. Wait, he's one of those people that like when they give you the option, like camera or picture,
but it looked like he did. But sometimes guys don't know what photos look good.
Here's the other thing: they don't care because they don't have the things running through their heads that we do. Like any picture we post, mm-hmm. it gets literally the shit torn apart. Yes. Like guys don't get that. No one's commenting on guys' photos and being like, really?
That really? True? Are you serious? Maybe you could shave your face before you take a photo.
You don't even have fashion sense. That's what you wore.
Somebody hasn't been using the face mask.
Do you even use an eye cream? Doesn't look like it. Or it's either people that are like,
oh, have you gotten a nose job?
Like you're aging. Oh my God. Like you look so bad. Or then like the comment below is like, enough Botox. And you're like, which one is it?
I do have which to one say, is Paige, it? You have a lot more people come for your looks than me.
Yeah.
I don't know if it's because you're so pretty.
Thank you.
Or because people know that like you're in the business of fashion. So they come for the thing that hurts
like.
You the most.
Yeah.
Because people come for me for like comedy.
Yeah.
Because they know that's like what I care about. Because they know if they called me like that I looked old, I'd be like, cool.
Yeah.
Like I don't care.
Right. Or if they told me like that's a bad joke, I'd be like, yeah, okay.
Yeah, who cares?
I wasn't trying.
That's the thing that trolls are good at. They're like a little brother.
They pinpoint your insecurity and then they write you about it.
It's so funny. Once someone said I looked like I ate myself after I had a bloaty day. I was like, ow.
You were like, I just shit myself in a bodega, okay? How dare you?
You don't know what someone's going through, okay? Okay. An ex made bad comments about my appearance. How do I stop thinking about it? Girly, you're normal. Because a guy once told me in third grade I had elf ears, and I still don't show my ears. I still wear my hair down every day because of that man.
Oh my gosh.
What I tell myself is like my fiance, my husband.
Oh my God, that's your first husband drop.
Yeah. Ew, I sound so old. Anyway, but being old is good, guys. We're normalizing.
Oh my God,
aging
you
gracefully.
Have a husband.
Oh, you don't have a husband?
You don't. Oh, sorry, you don't
have
a husband. Got it.
So, oh yeah, he loves me for my elf ears.
You
he
don't
thinks
have
they're adorable.
Elf ears, though.
When I was younger, I had the same size ears and smaller heads, so I looked like Orlando Bloom in. Lord
I thought you were
going to
just put your hair back and they were going to be pointy. They're not.
They like come out a little.
That's because you keep putting your hair behind your ears all the time.
Okay, mom.
You could literally. Yeah.
But like, for example, the hair you're wearing right now, I'd be self-conscious about my ears.
Got it.
Which is illogical and stupid. But that's because in third grade. Also, my crush in fourth grade told me I have man arms. I still wear, I know you guys are like, Hannah, you're so confident, you're so amazing, I know. I don't like showing my arms.
Also, with this ex, it's the same thing as that we just said about trolls. They pinpoint your insecurity. So whatever he said to you, he probably doesn't even think, but he knows that you think it.
Also, an ex who I know for a fact is still in love with me and very attracted to me told me he's not attracted to me anymore.
Such a lie.
Such a liar. Crazy.
You're just mad because I have a husband. Okay.
But yeah, for someone to say something that mean to you.
Yeah.
It's also like, oh, then why would you be with someone that you think is so ugly?
Right. Like, what's that say about you? That you just go around dating ugly girls? What a loser.
But think about it. Trolls say something that they think you're insecure by, not that they necessarily think.
Right.
So like, he's definitely knows that's your insecurity and stated it.
Right.
What's your biggest physical insecurity right now?
I don't really have one right now.
Go on Instagram later today. See what happens.
Yeah, let me post a picture and I'll let you know what it is.
Is it girls mostly commenting or guys?
I rarely get guys commenting on my appearance. It's pretty much girls. If a guy does do it, he DMs me. He at least has the courtesy to make it private. I say thank you so much for that.
Yeah, because he knows that he'll get destroyed if he says it publicly, but privately.
I also have a lot of people like saying that like I've actually had so much plastic surgery done and that's why like I could slightly be pretty, but I just don't admit it. And I'm like, bitch, if you think I wouldn't try and get that shit for free, you do not know me.
That's crazy.
But I'm not making a brand deal out of that. You don't know me.
I do feel like me and you have dealt with jealousy in our lives, but I've never dealt with it because I'm so pretty.
Right.
Which makes me question everything. Like, to go through life and you see what people target you for is what people are more jealous of.
Yeah.
For me, it's my amazing personality. Anyway, interning. Oh, this is for you. Interning in New York City law office this summer. Remember when we went to Boston and they thought you were there for the Harvard convention?
Okay, gigglers don't know this, but if you went to our Boston show, you do. I checked into the hotel. In my hotel, I've never been so offended. In my hotel, there happened to be a Harvard alumni conference happening. And I checked into the hotel and they said, Mr. Sorbo, thank you so much for checking in. Are you here for the Harvard alumni conference? And I said, how dare you think I'm ugly?
She goes, I'm not a fucking nerd. Ew.
But also part of me was flattered because I was like, I do have a fashion sense and I am smart. You're so right. But
only if it was Elwood's vibes. Anyway, this girl, definitely smarter than us, wants to know from you, nothing about anything important, but what flat shoes can I rock in the office and at happy hour?
What flat shoes can you rock in the office and at happy hour?
Because it's hot in New York.
I would go kitten heel.
Yeah.
I would do the classic New York City shoes and then you change. You can even, like, when I worked in an office, I would keep shoes in my desk drawers. No files, no paperwork.
Nope.
No pens. But I did have a plethora of
shoes. Not one pen
shoes.
To be found. I actually really like the kitten heels I wore. They're like square. They're open-toed. Is open-toed not cool for like a law firm?
I would say no.
One shoe that I love, and you could probably find a knockoff, and it's too hot for the summer, but like the Prada chunky loafers.
I think that would be very cute for an office.
For a law firm moment? Are you kidding me?
Loafers are really big. It's hard to like match a good outfit that's work appropriate with loafers. But I think if you're doing like a trouser situation and a kitten heel, chef's
kiss. Or a skirt with loafers and like some kind of high socks.
I don't know. Men make everything sexual. And you're like, I'm literally wearing a loafer.
Okay, and that is their problem. Right. That is them.
I know. But it is a double standard, but it's something like we have to live with. We live with it.
Why do people overshare on social media but don't confide in their friends in real life? Because they just want attention from strangers and they're lying.
That was really hard. I think that when you're an oversharer on Instagram, it's actually the opposite. Like you feel the masses, like telling like a mass amount of people mm-hmm. gets it out for you.
Yeah.
But you're not actually getting it out to one person.
You're like, not so you're, trying to solve the problem.
Right.
You just want to be heard.
You just want to be heard. That's why you will never catch me crying on Instagram stories.
There are two types of people.
Criers on Instagram people. And not criers.
Yeah.
Yeah. I could never.
I could never.
I don't have the emotional.
Something also like makes it less authentic to me when you in that moment are like, instead of crying, I need to film myself.
Right. Like I have been on Instagram stories after a full cry.
Mm-hmm.
But you would never know. Someone did DM me the other day. They're like, you're either high as hell or you just cried. And I was like, it is the latter, but I do wish it was the former.
It is, you know, when like if you, like a brand wants something from you and they're like, it's due in 3 hours. And you're like, okay, I love this pill. It's true. Fuck.
Yeah.
Also, what's hard about being a woman in society and not crying all the time is you have to like look presentable for things where men don't.
Right.
I even think about in comedy. I have to like do my hair and makeup for like the hour and a half beforehand where yeah. men are working on their jokes.
Right.
How is that fair? In the hours that I've been doing my makeup, men mm-hmm. are just preparing for the show at hand.
Honestly, even think about your wedding day.
Oh my.
We started getting ready at 11 a.m.
I started getting ready at 10 a.m. Dez was in a hot tub at like 3.
Yeah.
He showered like right before.
Isn't that crazy?
And he looked better than me.
One thing men have to get ready for.
He was like, I was like, do you guys want to go check on him? I told like the photographer that came back, like, we have no idea who he, where he is. We think he's like getting a sandwich at the deli or something.
Yeah.
We've lost him.
Definite words you want to hear on your wedding day. We've lost Des.
One thing we did on the wedding day, you guys, you knew I was going to bring it up eventually. We didn't even text good morning that day.
Wow.
Like, he didn't text me. He's normally the one who will. And I was like, oh. Either he's
did he
questioning
give you
everything.
Like did he write you like a letter or anything while you were getting ready?
We
like,
didn't
do
the
anything?
Letter writing.
No, he was like, maybe I'll be there, maybe I won't.
It was honestly, he was playing hard to get.
Yeah, it was a toss up.
I was
You're
nervy.
Like, are we going?
I was nervy. A couple hours in, I was like, oh, so we're not talking. And someone texted both of us like a photo, and I responded, and he responded also, but not like to each other. And I was like, okay, so he's alive. He's alive. He jumped in the ocean
Could
that
you
day.
Imagine actually having your wedding and, like, the person not showing up?
Yes.
How often do you think that happens?
I actually can imagine it because you live your life in such, like, a, and now we do this, and now we do this. And,
yeah.
And the world kind of just pushes you towards things, and then you're like, holy fuck, I'm getting married. Is this what I want?
Yeah.
It's actually much easier to just, like, freak out right before than to, like, maturely break up with someone.
Wow. I would love to know if there's any gigglers that have literally been jilted or have like jilted,
or have jilted
someone.
Themselves.
I think that there's no shame in leaving your wedding on the wedding day.
No shame. I mean, I do know people who like these weddings are so expensive.
Yeah.
Like they had everyone go to India for this wedding and the groom or the bride. I forget which one was like, we're not doing it.
I've had people like. Be like, should I just go through with the wedding and deal with it after, or should I break up with him now?
Yeah.
And they've chosen to like end it now.
Smart.
Yeah.
Smart. Because, yeah, people, it's your wedding. People are not going to be upset, like, oh, I didn't get to get free drinks
if
tonight.
If you're at the wedding, though, and the bride or groom doesn't show up to the ceremony.
Hell no. No, no, no. No.
Do you go to the reception, though? There's all
absolutely.
That food.
Absolutely.
They already paid for the open bar.
Absolutely. I'm literally telling all my friends to get on Hinge, hit up every hot guy in the place, and be like, let's fucking go get some strippers. I'm single.
Yeah.
I'm single and ready to mingle tonight. I'm fucking tonight.
Just for the drama, I want to be invited to a wedding where some fuck shit happens.
We asked our judge, our officiant. They don't do the whole... Does anyone have any anything to say? They don't do that anymore. He's like, that's just movies. And I was like, we could use that drama. But
yeah.
We were pro-drama.
I don't think I would want. Because I have asshole friends. Like someone, you would stand up and be like, just kidding.
Dude, yeah, my wedding was so rowdy.
The rowdiest wedding I've ever been to. It was like a playoff game.
Dude, I was scared. The crowd was so hot. Des and I went back to the green room and we were like, that crowd is hot. The laughs were a minute, Patrick. And then Mercedes apparently fell.
Yep.
And then went on to, she was like filming in the back, just yelling. But everyone else was yelling too.
How'd you feel about the Instagram? I know that Des was like, hey, we're not like going to post anything. How did you feel that we all did projecting it?
You guys did amazing. Okay, but I have to say, I wasn't on my phone really. So I didn't get to see all the ones that people tagged me in.
Yeah.
Because it was nice that I could have been on my phone all night looking
at everything.
You were very
in the moment.
Yeah, because then I'd be like reposting stuff and you're not in it. I didn't see any of it. But like we have the professional photos.
Yeah.
The ones that were really good, my people were like sending me.
Yeah.
The fact that Nima got the video of you catching the bouquet.
We are forever indebted
Paige,
to him.
You almost ate shit.
I know.
Imagine if
nobody's talking about it enough. People didn't really. Some people noticed. Some people were like, we saw you almost fall. And I was like, but
well,
I.
Well, you were on a full sprint and then had to stop.
The athleticism that took over
with
my
heels
body.
On. Also, she was browning out at that point.
Fully browned out. What shoes was it? I was wearing like a full.
Yeah, you had a slippy slide moment. And if you.
If I had fallen, I mean, America's Funniest Home Videos. It would have actually been great for the pod, not for me personally and my like self-esteem.
That's
but
how
it would
sick
have been
we are.
Great.
You know, people were messaging me. They were like, whoever says you guys don't get the pod out on time right after your wedding weekend, you guys did it. And they're like, you're amazing. I'm like, no, I have a very unhealthy work-life balance.
Someone commented and was like, doesn't even count. They like cheated and like, ew, and all of this. And some giggler was like, fuck off. It's from the podcast.
That's the
like,
point.
Yeah. You don't get our highbrow humor.
How do you handle... the way we pivot. How do you handle overstimulation? Been struggling at home and work
lately. Don't leave the home.
Is that what we struggle with? Overstimulation?
Well, I'm still in my full depression and anxiety mode, and so I can't be stimulated by anything other than Netflix.
It's funny because when I went to a comedy festival was the only time I've ever been at an event loving the stimulation and loving socializing with people. It's because I was on
because
this like
high. Because it's
like to do. Yeah, it's like when you, if you liked animals, let's say, and you were in a place with a ton of puppies, you'd be like, yes, 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 yes. But when you're sensitive to energies.
Think about how bad that room would smell, though.
When you're sensitive to energies, like when you go outside New York City, you're getting a lot of shit.
Here's the thing, though, about New York City. It's like the most congested city that it's so easy to feel like you're alone. I don't mean that in like a like I'm so alone. Like, I don't mean it in that way. I mean like.
Yeah, you don't feel you like people are
around,
on your shit.
Yeah, you can be around a ton of people. Not one person is looking. It's the only city that you can straight up cry on the street. Not one person's looking at you.
They're like, get it out. No one is going to ask you if you're okay. Everyone is just like, honestly, can't wait for my next cry.
That's why everyone's shitting on the street.
No one cares. Including myself. Including me. That's what I'm doing.
No one cares.
Oh, God. So, yeah, if you're feeling overstimulated, I mean, you could look into ADD stuff. I definitely have ADD. Look at me just diagnosing people. You could be. Also, you're probably overstimulated. I don't know.
I think
I'm overstimulated by this conversation.
My best advice is to do like a self-care thing. And I don't mean like sit and like light a candle and like meditate and do a face mask. Mm-hmm. Like not that type of self-care. Mm-hmm. I was feeling really overwhelmed the other day and I turned on like my Netflix show, turned my phone off, sat on my bed and reorganized all my drawers. And that was like the most self-care moment. I felt productive when it was like something stupid, but it was like just me alone with like my
Do you
shows.
Find there's moments where you like can't do anything? Like you can't brush your teeth, like you can't.
Yeah.
Cuz that's how I feel.
That's your depression?
My depression is like at nighttime, I'm like, I can't even
move.
Go to brush my teeth and like do my face. Like I'm just like falling asleep on the couch.
Yeah,
I'm done. And I have moments of the day where I'm super productive, like way too productive, to then like I couldn't do anything.
This is actually very interesting. So Craig's dad, I was with him the other weekend and he was talking about some book he's reading. Don't remember the name, but he was saying that if you're like indecisive, when you have a decision to make, you say 1, 2, 3 in your head and then you just make the decision. Like there's no second guessing. So recently when I like was like, okay, you have to wash your face before bed, but it was like I was like, I can't get up. I just said 1, 2, 3 and I got up and I did it.
Okay, that's what people say about your mornings. Like all you have to do is just do it.
Yeah.
But like when you're depressed, that's not good advice to be like, just do it.
Yeah.
Just
that's
do
true.
It. But someone I watched a TikTok about someone saying the difference between really successful people and people who like don't want to be that successful is decision making.
Yeah.
That successful people, whether it's right or wrong, are just making the decision where other people will stay idle for like as long as
I also
as
saw one that it was like they wake up at 4 a.m. and I was like,
absolutely
fuck
not.
Off.
Absolutely not. But yeah, I think for me, I have to find things.
I find you pretty decisive though.
Oh no, I'm very decisive. Yeah. I just can't do basic tasks.
Who cares?
In the house.
Hire someone.
Absolutely.
You're a wife now. You can literally hire help.
I do think that I, because as a kid, now it's full therapy mode, but because as a kid I was forced to like play so much
and have
sports
such a routine
and have such a routine. Like that's all I knew. Like I had a whole career that now I like get off on being like, I'm not even gonna clean that, when it's like, no, you're actually just hurting yourself.
I get that.
Like
though.
That's my rebellion.
Yep.
Even Des was like, let's play volleyball tomorrow. And I played like 2 games. And I'm like, I'm done. And he's like, really? I'm like, I was forced to play sports my whole life without ever being able to say no. And he's like, this is a weird kink you have. Because he's like, why would you want to stop? And I'm like, because I can't.
Yeah. It's just you being able to make the decision.
Like other people probably don't feel that free to be like, yeah, I'm not going to wash the dishes today. But for me, I'm like, yeah.
Third game of volleyball? I don't think so. And it's like, okay, Hannah.
But anyway, Des has been making me play volleyball during our honeymoon. Which I like. Also, we fostered a dog for our honeymoon.
Wow.
Her name's Molly, and
oh, the white one.
She's kind of an angel.
I saw her on the Instagram.
She's
Instagram
a literal
story.
Angel. All she wants to do is lie next to you and get pets. So
great.
She's
all by her.
No, like actually,
adopter,
you
mean.
Can adopt her. She's amazing because your schedule. I don't think it's good, but you guys, if you're in New York or Long Island, she's like the dog that's everyone's favorite at the shelter. Mm-hmm. They let her sit in the front, and all the other
How
dogs are like,
she?
"What is it like?" She's like 6 or 7.
Okay.
She's from the South. She was just like living outdoors, like chained up.
Aww.
And she has like little marks on her elbows from like lying down on the hot ground.
Oh my God.
No, she's been like abused. She is the sweetest baby I've ever met.
What kind of dog is that?
She's like a lab with maybe a mix of something else, but she's like a white lab with a little, she's so freaking cute. But she's the dog that they let her sit with the secretaries in the front. Mm-hmm. And all of the dogs are in the kennels.
She's the favorite.
Yeah, the dog's like,
how many weeks are you fostering it?
We were going to do just a week, but now because I came to the city and Dez is staying back with her, we might do 2 weeks. But our goal is to get her adopted. And
how quickly do people adopt?
It could happen in a second.
Yeah. Like, but you could have it for a day.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But we're still looking for someone to adopt Molly. If you want a couch potato, but she also loves walking. And but she slept on me all day the other day.
I love that.
She watched a Johnny.
How did Romeo feel about it?
Romeo's in the city with Aiden.
Oh, okay.
But that's the thing. Everyone keeps saying you guys have to keep her, when I'm like, we can't. We literally have two pets that do not fuck with other pets.
Yeah.
Romeo does not like
Butter other
dogs.
Doesn't know what the fuck's going on.
Butter is not okay.
She's like, we didn't like dogs. Now all of a sudden we host them at our home. We don't
Butter
know
had
when
to deal
they're
with
leaving.
All the fostering. Some
no,
of them should
Butter
be tough.
Butter has had it.
Butter's had it, and she's actually disgusted.
Yeah. She's like, cool, you got married. I wasn't there.
Yeah, she's not happy about that. Okay, final one. I have a crush on a guy who has a toxic past. He's not with his ex anymore, who's also toxic.
What?
There's wait. Layers here.
Yeah, wait. Start from the beginning.
I have a crush on a guy who has a toxic past.
What does that mean? I need that broken down.
He's probably had a really toxic relationship with someone.
Okay, who hasn't?
And he's blamed, saying he's probably told her his ex is also toxic. So it's basically like if you wanted to date Johnny Depp.
I think that if you're in a toxic relationship, mm-hmm. whether like, okay, he could have been the toxic one and he did certain things to you that now you've become toxic because mm-hmm. you're reacting. Mm-hmm. Regardless, you're both toxic. It was a bad relationship. I don't think you should judge anyone based on it.
I don't think you should. However, some people, I think, love the toxic.
Love
and they
it.
Want the toxic. And they don't want to have a healthy relationship. And like guys who are like, oh no, I just love crazy girls. It's like, no, you like driving people crazy and you like
yeah.
the toxic. You like the drama.
As a Scorpio Italian woman, I love a little fire. Like, I love a fight. I do. I just do. I love, like, a random, like, fuck you. And I came from a relationship that, like, there was
none.
No emotion.
Yeah.
Like, no fighting, which was amazing. But then there was also no, like,
extreme intimacy
at all. Mm-hmm. So then to have a relationship where there's like an abundance of intimacy that it's almost like, oh my God, mm-hmm. close your legs. Like, you're annoying me. You have to find a balance. And I really don't feel like you find it until you're in your later 20s. Mm-hmm. Like, there's no way.
It's funny because Dez is a Scorpio. And I'm telling you, Dez loves a fight, but I don't give it to him.
Okay, you can't keep us from it because we will find something.
But he, like, I think he's, because he's in his 40s.
He's tired.
He's exhausted.
Yeah.
But so he has fights with himself.
I can see, like, Craig and I will get into a disagreement about something. And in my head, I'm like, damn, if I was 24, I would have exploded
yes.
and made this so much bigger. But because I'm tired,
yep.
I'm like, all right.
Like, Dez laughs
you.
About
like,
shit now
care.
That I feel like when he was younger, he wouldn't.
I would have gone nuts.
Or he just, like, knows when shit is just with him and he deals with it.
But I genuinely think you need a balance. Like, with my ex-boyfriend, I'd be like, slam one door. One door and I'll be fine. Like, say get the fuck out and we will be better.
I am so scared of a fight. I hate a fight.
But sometimes you have to get those emotions out.
No, you're 100% right, because I'm the girl that will never fight with you and one day go, hey, I don't think this is working.
Yes.
Out. I'm that girl.
Yeah,
and
you
I've done
are.
It
you
times.
Like, you.
I'm like would, that with friendships too.
You
like,
would be
I
the person.
I see one thing and it's like, you'll never see me again.
Ever. You are Johnny Depp. You'll never look at these eyes again.
I will never. Dude, I will could, never look into people's eyes again.
Your ex could walk in this room and you would act like you'd never met him. I love that though.
I've never like. I've gone cold turkey with all my exes except one really toxic one who would make me get coffee with him. But don't worry, I ended that.
It's kind of crazy that you could go cold turkey. Like, I've at least gone back to every single ex once.
I've never. Oh, no. I did hook. I hooked up with British Dave. But, like, we didn't
he
really
count.
Date.
He's a
date.
Gem of a human.
He's a gem.
Does he like, know you got married?
Well, it's funny because Dez asked me. Dez was like, have any of your exes hit you up?
Yeah. Did anyone say, like, congrats?
No, because that's, like, anyone I was with, like, we don't talk anymore yeah. like that. And I asked Dez, and he was like, none of my serious ones, but a couple hookups. And I was like,
no way.
But think about it. If it's, like, serious, that's, like, weird to be like, congrats on getting married. I don't know.
I don't think any of my exes have even gotten married. See, they were the problem, not
obviously.
Me.
No, British Dave, we hadn't hooked up in a while. And then he was like, hey, like, I'm leaving to go to Australia tomorrow. I'm probably not going to be back in America, like, for a really long time. I'd love to get drinks.
When was this? You're like, I'm literally getting married in 4 hours.
No, this was, like, years ago. This was years ago.
Oh, I do kind of remember that.
Yeah, yeah.
And he never came back?
No.
To America.
But I gave him a goodbye.
Yeah.
Okay, now we can talk about the wedding.
Okay. I don't know if this phrase has been used too much or, like, if it's a popular opinion or if it's unpopular, but this is my opinion. I hated it.
I'm so happy you came with this hot take today. I'm so happy. Continue.
I thought that...
But you're also coming off a really good wedding.
I'm coming off
you're a little jaded.
I'm coming off of an impossible theme to recreate. I'm coming off Hampton's disco garage. I mean, everything was encompassed in this wedding.
Bouquet in the face.
Oh, it was
joy.
Just comedy.
So try to be unbiased.
I'm trying.
What were your expectations for it? Like, what did you envision?
I envisioned, like, fairy tale gorgeousness. I thought this looked like a bad Halloween party. I thought that, like, the red and the black, now it's not my aesthetic, but here's what I was annoyed about. It's not hers either. That's not her aesthetic.
You feel like she's playing a part.
She's playing a part. Like, her wedding dress.
There's a girl on TikTok who I started following who would say, like, what celebrity, what dress they should wear for their wedding, or she'd style certain things, and she came up with all these gorgeous, kind of gothic-looking long wedding dresses
yes.
that she could have worn that were stunning, and she was like, I wish she wore one of these.
I wanted from her, I wanted, like, old school Godfather, like, gothic Italian. I wanted gold and white, and I wanted him to be tatted in, like, a sick Tom Ford suit, and I wanted hers to be very, like...
So you thought this out?
No, I thought this out. I thought the corset micro mini with the insane veil. Now, as a good Catholic schoolgirl, I thought the Blessed Mother Mary on her veil was very, like, sacrilegious. Like, I just thought it was weird. Mm-hmm. Like, I didn't love it. Mm-hmm. I liked all the wedding guest dresses. I think Chloe actually looked the best. I think her wearing a gold crown to someone else's wedding is the main character energy I wanted.
I did see that. She Sierra'd it.
She totally did. She was like, watch this, Kendall and Sierra.
But I
will
like
be wearing a
she
crown.
She really wanted her guests to go off. Like, she wanted them to have fun with it.
Yes. I also have a real problem with Penelope's hair being red. I didn't love that.
Why?
I just don't think it's like, I just don't like it. Alabama Barker scares the fuck out of me. Her lip liner, she like, I mean, she could punch me in the face and I'd say thank you. Like, she's terrifying. I just didn't like it. Like, I didn't like it.
Do you think that the internet felt similar?
I don't know. I didn't even really read anything that people were, like, saying because I think they were so excited that they got married.
Yeah.
that I didn't even see.
Did people know that there were going to be so many? Because I thought they were just going to do the small wedding ceremony. Like, I thought they were just going to do Vegas. And I thought they were just going to. And, like, I didn't even know this was happening. I wish she did a long gown.
Yeah. I mean, it was basically sponsored by Dolce & Gabbana.
Oh, yeah.
Like, which I feel like all the sisters that wore Dolce & Gabbana looked great. Like, I thought all of their dresses were great. I think it fit the vibe. But, like, she could have come out in a sick
She basically
dress.
Wore, like, a Y2K corset with a mini.
A white mini skirt and, like, Mary on her veil. And it was, like, 1,000 feet long.
She seems so happy, which we love.
We love that.
We love. You know what? I think it's because we want her to have a moment. And, like, yet again, I feel like the other people had moments.
I just think it looked like a costume party. I also think that, like, I am a traditional wedding dress girl because I feel like if you do a trend for your wedding, you're going to look back on it in 20 years and be like, I can't believe I actually picked that.
Well, this is the question. In 10 years, is she going to look back and be like, oh, remember when I thought I was like a rock star?
Yeah, I don't know.
Do you think that like he's Kanye-ing it where he's like kind of like this is my vision? She's like, yeah, babe.
I know. I think
that
she just
loves. Is this what happens when you let the guy plan it?
I think she just loves him so much that like the things he likes, she's like, I like it too. And she might like it, but like, I don't know.
I do notice Penelope reminds me so much of Courtney. Like she has the best resting Courtney bitch face.
Yeah.
And I'm obsessed with, like, little girls with resting bitch faces.
I loved Kim being blonde, though, at it.
Yes.
She also had pee. She had a pee on her acrylics.
People did message me. Someone is following me on Instagram. I'm a little worried about my nails, though, because they haven't budged. And I feel like the woman put straight up concrete on my nails. And I don't even know how to get them off at this point.
Is that a tip? Or is that a straight acrylic nail?
She did something I've never witnessed. Okay. It's a tip, but like she like made it out of clay.
She whittled it.
Okay, I don't know what the fuck happened, but anyway, I did H&D. Her putting Pete was fun. Was Pete not there?
No, because he had his last night on SNL. Craig and I got into a small spat about this, he said. His take was stupid, but we had a full-on debate. He said, if Kim and Pete were really real, wouldn't he have been at Courtney's wedding? And I said, yeah, but it was his last night on SNL. And he said, yeah, but didn't they sit down to plan Courtney's wedding? And I said, I'm not changing my wedding plans if your brother got a new girlfriend. Mm-hmm. I said, that's crazy. Why would I do that? Mm-hmm. He then conceded because he realized that I was right.
Or it's like more of a real relationship that he feels like he doesn't need to cancel his career shit to show that he's at this wedding.
Right. Like, I didn't think him doing his SNL thing was like.
No, it means they're in a real relationship.
Yeah,
like,
he's like, I have
to
do this.
They had to prioritize shit.
Right.
And also she's had like a bunch of wedding celebrations.
She got married like 3 times in this past week.
I do love that it's in Italy, though. It made me hungry. The whole thing made me hungry.
Yeah, me too. Is that weird?
Yeah, for some penne alla vodka.
I was like, wow, I wonder what like the food is at the at this reception.
That's probably amazing.
I was like, why aren't we seeing that?
And Stassi was there, too.
Okay, now Stassi's wedding.
Yes.
The epitome of what I want from an Italian wedding.
Yes.
Like, I want Frank Sinatra playing in the background. Yep. I want long, white, like,
I want people throwing gnocchi around.
Yeah, I want to walk down the aisle and people be throwing pasta at me.
Parmesan being sprinkled.
Hello?
An onion ring for the ring. Anyway, you guys, we love you so much.
Oh, that's it? We're done?
Yeah. We, like, Patrick gave us the 5-minute mark. We have so much to talk about. You're going to have to wait till next week. Nana Slogata is still posting wedding photos. Some of them of me. I'm like, Nana, I look like a beached whale. You have to. My Nana, I don't think she can see.
Her first picture was her. And I was like, I fucking love that.
If I posted the photos of her, she'd kill me.
Yeah.
She can't see. I don't think she can see, but
Also, I'm going to be on The Daily Pop on Thursday. We're doing summer trends. I am the E! Shop Girl Summer stylist.
Yes.
So for like the next couple of months, I'll be on E! Doing like different summer trends and like different things. So my first one is on Thursday morning.
Which hosts are on The Daily Pop?
How dare you?
No, is it Morgan?
I don't know. Oh. They switch them out.
That is so exciting.
Yes.
Also, I believe we sold out DC. I think we have a couple left for New York and a couple left for Boston. It'll be a different show if you've been to Boston shows. And I have some new stand-up dates in the fall that I'll be announcing soon. And this is our merch that I'm wearing that I've been wearing every day for 2 months.
That's what got me shadow banned. So buy it.
Bye. We love you. Mwah.